A major step forward for the Baha Mar project today as it's being sold to a big player in the resort industry. Good evening, everyone. I'm Chris Arnes. Thank you so much for joining us. The nation's chief made the announcement today. And as Janae Noel Ferguson tells us tonight, this will provide a much needed economic stimulus in which thousands of Bahamians will reap the benefit.
Prime Minister the Right Honorable Perry Christie called it a new day for the Baha Mar development as its new owner, C.T.F. Holdings Limited, has already begun an extensive marketing plan for the property marred with construction and financial challenges. The Prime Minister announced that the stalled multi-billion dollar project is now back on track.
Despite the challenges that this development has endured, construction of the property has commenced once again. And Baha Mar is now back on a path for the phased opening beginning in April 2017 and full completion by the next fall.
He added that the project is anticipated to generate some 315,000 annual air passenger arrivals and thousands of jobs for Bahamians.
And the reality is that in the coming months, economic opportunities will be realized in more and more homes throughout the Bahamas. Bahama will create an estimated 5,500 to 7,000 jobs for Bahamians. Furthermore, Mr. Speaker, the economic and fiscal effects will not only be felt by those Bahamians employed, but will also benefit a plethora of Bahamian businesses, both large and small.
Mr. Christie acknowledged that much has been said about the concessions that the new developer will receive, as it was rumored that Bahamian citizenship was promised to thousands of Chinese as a part of the deal.
And it is not unique to this project that concessions will be provided on a proportionate basis to the development. Most countries offer concessions, trade agreements contemplate concessions, and further, our laws provide for concessions to all qualifying investors. The previous government also granted concessions to investors, including Bahama.
Meanwhile, Mr. Christie said as it relates to the head of agreement for this project, those documents remain sealed by court order. Newly appointed leader of the opposition, Loretta Butler Turner, had concerns about the brokering of the deal for the new project. Meanwhile, Tourism Minister, the Honorable Obi Wilchcombe, applauded the move.
Just 3 months ago, the Prime Minister told us the work had begun, been mobilized at Baha Mar. And once again, we're hearing that this morning. Mr. Speaker, I would like to find out exactly how much money is it that has been put into this project since it has been restarted.
What we're seeking to do is get the economy growing 4 to 5%. At the present time, this rate is not good to build the country upon. We need to get a rate that's going to be able to cause for more economic opportunities, more job opportunities, and it's going to make our country stronger. So that's what's imperative, and to get that to happen, we need to get the brands, we need to get the inventory, we need to get the airlift, and I think we're heading in the right direction.
Now, Mr. Christie said the expansion of the project called for the creation of new attractions, the replacement of the Crystal Palace pod, turning it into an offshore island themed park. He says it will bode well for the country's economy. Janae Noel Ferguson, ZNS Network News.